The 10-Pin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.
Welcome to the 10-Pin Bowling Show. We are at Gosford City Bowl, and you're watching continuing coverage of the Interbowl Senior Masters. Today's match is an exciting one. We have Australian representative Bob Whybrow taking on local favourite Rob Szumski. We'll send you upstairs to the commentary team, and we wish them good luck in high scoring.
Thank you very much, Dennis, and welcome to all our viewers to this week's edition of the 10-Pin Bowling Show. I'm Michael Tran, and we're covering the Interbowl Senior Masters from Campbelltown City Lanes in New South Wales. Bob Whybrow is our first player this week. 56 years of age, has six perfect 300 games to his credit. He's also representing the Australian team to go away to Guam this year. Welcome, Brenton Davey.
Thanks very much, Michael. Bob's first offering, half pocket hit for a 10-pin. Bob Whybrow in the last Asian Zone Seniors Championships in Manila in 2009. Was runner-up in the Asian Senior Masters. Fine bowler, been around for a long, long time. Slightly unconventional technique. Ooh, and that's an unusual miss for Bob. He's an extremely good spare shooter. I can only think there might be a little bit of nerves in that one.
Perhaps.
Our next player up is Rob Szumski. Local bowler from Campbelltown City Lanes, 53 years of age, has three 300 games to his name and has a league average of 216. One of two left-handers in this field. We've seen Rob previously in the 10-pin bowling show and off to a flying start.
Oh, that's a great left-hander shot, that one. Few revolutions on the ball there, and as you can see, turning up nice and high into the pocket. Flushed it all out, no 7-pin there.
Sensational opening offering there. Now, Bob Whybrow, an early 11-pin deficit, needs to get it going. Unusual bent elbow swing, but he's made it work for himself over a number of years.
Nicely kicked out the 4-pin on that occasion. As you mentioned, Brenton, very, very unorthodox. The straight elbow.
Not something that anyone would coach. We're all taught to have straight arm swing, free swing. Bob muscles the swing, has the bent elbow, but he makes it work for him. Rob Szumski, whoa, that was inside. Long way inside the previous effort. Maybe trying to really stuff that double in there, get out to an early big lead. Leaves just the 4-pin.
Plenty of revolutions there on the left-hand side, and I don't say that in jest.
I know what you're saying. Lefties don't normally rev the ball. I know.
They normally don't have to.
Steady on. Anyway, all banter aside, Rob Szumski makes the spare.
Yeah, stay clean through two.
Has an 11-pin lead.
But no, if you play with a lot of revolutions down that left-hand side, there's definitely the pattern will hold up long enough for you to play it. And we'll see how long it holds up for Rob down that side. Now, Bob Whybrow to contest his third frame.
Ah, far and away is the best shot, that one. Again, you know, straight angle, straight up the boards. You're not going to see massive amounts of hook from the seniors. Brought up in eras where, you know, literally straight was greater, tougher lane conditions, bowling balls that weren't as aggressive as they are today. Learned to put different rotation on the ball, play with a little bit of speed, play straighter angles.
Much more reliant on accuracy. Rob now for his third frame, and
oh, unlucky there.
Yeah, great shot.
Good aggressive shot. Have a look at him through the bottom of the swing. Big follow through. Didn't leave any in the bag on that one. A couple of pins got in each other's way there, and we now have an even match.
Here's that head pin getting chopped out by one laying on the deck there. Otherwise, it could very possibly have carried. Rob now to go back and spare.
Which he does. And you watch Rob, and just go, I mean, there are a few seniors out there with some pretty hot hands as far as Reds are concerned. Won't see him in this particular tournament, but Mike Kennedy from Victoria. And Geelong throws as many Reds as just about anyone, with the probable exception of Jason Belmonte. And he started life up until about his mid-30s as a full roller. Went to the United States, learned how to throw lots of Reds. He's quite exciting to watch.
Well, there you go, never too late to learn how to throw it.
Whoa, that one's crossed over. Got the big break there.
And that is a huge break in the context of this game. Opened the first frame, but ever since, has put strikes on the board.
And if I know, Bobby probably went back and apologised to Rob there.
Looking a bit sheepish there in his chair, isn't he?
That he is. You know, Bob's a pretty quiet, shy sort of a guy. Sort of guy that goes out and wins sportsman's awards.
Oh, yes.
Rob Szumski now under a little bit of pressure. Well, back in the pocket again. One thing I've noticed with Rob, the ball that he's using is a very, very, very mild reactive ball. Ball with a weakish core, not a particularly strong reactive cover. And he's actually relying on the revolutions in a rotation to get the job done. Bob Whybrow throwing less revs, using a much more aggressive ball.
Yeah, look, I'd be inclined to use a less reactive ball, seeing as how most high-rev players can hit light and splash the pins around, but we'll see what happens. Well, let's go down to Dennis with Bob.
I'm here with Bob Whybrow. Bob, after four frames, you seem to be solid.
Not at the foul line, and missed that 10-pin in the first frame. A little bit of TV nerves for the first time, but ball's hitting well.
You're used to dealing with a bit of nerves. I mean, you're a four-time Australian representative, and the shirt you're wearing is from the men's Abu Dhabi Asian Championships.
That's correct, yes. I was lucky enough, fortunate enough to bowl well enough to bowl myself into the team and went away with the guys and the girls. And we had a fantastic time in Abu Dhabi. Yeah, came back with one gold medal, which was fantastic for Lexi.
Yeah, it's a funny thing about luck. Luck is determined by where opportunity intersects preparation, and you've definitely done that. You won a silver medal in 2009. So it's just great to see you on the show, and we wish you good luck for the rest of the match.
Thank you, Dennis.
Your sport has an enormous potential for growth. We urgently need to increase the number of league bowlers who are registered members of Tenpin Bowling Australia, your national sporting organisation. Tenpin Bowling Australia, bowling centre proprietors, centre managers, our champion bowlers, and even bowling equipment suppliers are all united and working together to make the sport even better. We need you to play your part and become a registered member now.
If you really love to hit the lanes,
if you really love your sport,
if you really love to bowl with friends,
if you love to feel young,
if you really love bowling like us,
if you really love bowling with family and friends,
if you really want to support your sport,
if you really love your sport, I mean love it, you'll become a registered member now.
But hold on your hats, folks. This is number 12 for the perfect game of 300. He loves it. George Palingos, not too sure how many he's shot now, but he's shot a perfect game 300 to be the 2009 Melbourne Tenpin Cup champion.
Welcome back to the Tenpin Bowling Show. I'm here with Rob Szumski. Rob, you haven't missed.
No, I'm bowling reasonably well. I've just got to get a little bit more carry, maybe trip out that last pin. I'll be happy if I do that.
Well, you got to be pleased. You're dialed in and you're just waiting for that final pin to go, and I'm sure you'll be all right.
I'm hoping so.
I'm sure you will. We'll send you back upstairs to the commentary team.
Thanks for that, Dennis. And I think you said it well there when Rob needs a little bit of carry. And he's been a little bit unfortunate up to this point. He's hit four pockets and only one strike to show for it, but plenty of time left. Bob Whybrow now. getting up to start the fifth frame and hopefully put on another strike.
And hits the pocket again. Same as the first frame, though, that flat 10-pin. See the 6-pin on the second from the right, just lays in the gutter. Not quite enough energy to jump out, take out the 10.
Notice a bit of a wry smile from Bob when he left that, as he left the lane. Probably knew it was going to happen.
He probably also thought it might have been karma for that Brooklyn that he got as well. So missed the last one he went at, not this time.
No, don't miss two of those in a row.
Just as an aside, you know, before the previous break, the advertisement for 10-pin bowling Australia, I fully concur with every sentiment in that particular advertisement. You know, I urge all the bowlers watching this show to join the TBA, help the national sporting body, raise the profile of 10-pin bowling in Australia, govern the sport. Rob Szumski still not getting that carry.
He must have run over a black cat in the car park or something, because he's been splendid so far. But now going back to your point there, Brenton, it is a very worthwhile cause. Oh!
Looking at that, the stucker over slid slightly, the line, let's have a look. Yeah, see that that sliding foot there, it twisted a lot at the line, which indicates to me that might have overslid slightly. And of course, that affected his timing and his ability to hit a target. And as a result,
yes,
that's his first miss. He's in a bit of trouble now. Bob Whybrow now looks to take advantage of that open. Oh!
Oof. Kicked out the 4 from the 4-9 combination. Going very high up here in the pocket.
Going high in the pocket. Again, though, you know, people say, oh, yeah, he's been lucky. But the reality is that if you've got the ball speed and the angle of entry correct, then you're going to keep the pins low, you're going to keep them flying low around the deck, and you're going to get those trip outs.
Yes, and the line Bob is throwing, he's not giving away too much of the pocket. He's straight up there and in, which means he's got a lot more, I suppose, margin for error when he hits the pocket. So he's not going to leave too many splits throwing that kind of angle of entry.
Rob Szumski now really needs to find that carry that he talked about with Dennis a bit earlier. See what happens here. Well, that looked like it hit target. I reckon it might have been just a little bit soft on the speed. Might have slowed the ball down just ahead to see if he could improve the carry. As a result, it went through right through the nose. It left the 2 and 4 pins.
Now, look, this is a 10-frame game, so if he was going to make an adjustment, he needed to make one really quickly, and one would say he needs to make another. He's got to find something. He's got to find it quick.
That's the thing with one-game matches. You live and die by the decisions that you make early with line and release and equipment. If you make the right decision from the start, well, you're in good shape. If not, you've got to make a decision really quickly and just, you know, have faith in your decision-making process. Then when you make a decision, go out there, trust that decision, and just execute a good shot. Bob Whybrow now with a 21-pin lead. Snaps the 10-pin out there.
Not too sure he liked it off the hand, but he took a little bit of a wider path to the pocket here. And
a little bit more loft, I think.
And there was enough reaction in the back end to snap that 10 out.
A little bit more loft, which delayed the reaction a little bit. Quite often, a little bit of extra loft might delay the reaction, but it gives a stronger reaction in the back end. A little bit extra angle of entry in the pocket, snap the 10 out. Rob Szumski needs to respond. And he's made a ball change. I don't think it came off quite as nicely as he would have liked, but it's definitely a different ball.
Crossing over Brooklyn's side, leaving the 4-7 combination. It's getting to the point now where he must close.
Oh, this spare is just a must.
Well done. Under the heat of the moment, he's picked up that 4-7, stays within the match.
still only 23 pins, so he's not out of it yet. I suspect he's going to need a little bit of help from Bob if he's to progress to the next round.
Running out of frames, and Bob is bowling extremely well. Not giving away the pocket, so one would suggest he's not going to miss from here.
Oh, it's high. Oh, he's had a couple of breaks this match. A Brooklyn hit, he's had a couple of high hits that have tripped out probable splits. But he's taken advantage of them so far. This is the final match of the top half of the draw for the Interbowl Senior Masters. Winner of this match goes through to the quarterfinal stage and will play Greg Williams, who won last week's match, you might remember, against Derek Wright. It's definitely made a ball change. See if he can find the way into the pocket. Giving that a bit more room. Oh no.
My goodness. Another great shot made here by Rob Szumski, and has absolutely no luck with that seven pin.
The only thing I can say about that is that breakpoint might have just been a hair long down the lane. It's the only reason I can think of. The four pin would have gone around the seven there, and it went around at warp. It whistled around that.
Did it ever. He's got to be feeling a bit ripped off, and well, not too many left-handers can actually say that.
Settle down.
I'm right on it today. I actually feel sorry for Rob.
It's amazing. I'm left-handed, and it's amazing the amount I cop from you. Anyway, it's down to Dennis with Bob.
I'm here with Rob Szumski. You have 8 frames, mate. You're throwing the ball good.
I thought I was doing quite well, but I'm not carrying, so I've made a couple of changes, changed balls, and lost a couple of frames in doing it. Shot's still good. I just need that extra carry.
Well, we'll see how you can do it for the rest of the match. You're still in with a chance.
Oh, I haven't given up yet, but I just need another strike now.
All right, mate. We'll wish you well for the rest of the match.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. After 8 frames, here's Bob Whybrow. Bob, you're throwing the ball solid.
Yeah, Dennis, the ball's coming off pretty well, liking the feel. Just jumping a little bit at probably 30 feet, so just need to give it a bit more room, I think.
So basically what you're saying is as the ball's transitioning off the taper of the oil, you're looking at the ball reaction, you're not quite happy with that.
No, not happy at all, but scoring okay, so I might just leave things the way they are.
Good idea. Mate, we'll see you at the end of the match.
Thanks, Dennis.
Thanks, Dennis, and for information on the 10 Pin Bowling Show, please visit our website, www.10pinbowlingshow.com.au.
We're up in the ninth frame now, top of the ninth frame, and as the fisticuffs in the commentary box have settled down, we've still got a match on down here, and Bob Whybrow still needs to finish this match off properly, because Rob Szumski can strike out for 203. Wow, now. Bob was talking about the ball jumping. That one certainly did.
Yeah, definitely did. Right off the spot there. And he's placing the ball on the lane with a fair bit of loft. Now, that would suggest that the ball, when it's getting to the break point, is taking off just that much more. And that's what's causing the ball to go through the beak. But just needs to stay clean.
Stay clean, decent counts, and it would be enough for a win. But might not strike him there. He has given Rob Szumski just a little bit of a sniff.
Ooh, tiny bit of a peek. Bob Whybrow at this point can go 9 spare 9 in the 10th for 203. And Rob Szumski would need to strike out to get there at this point.
But must strike on this shot. Gone back to the ball he was using originally. It certainly looks a little bit jumpier, just not getting the, not quite getting the right. He's been there and thereabouts for the whole match. It's been, you know.
I was about to say those exact words, there or thereabouts. But unfortunately, this carry hasn't been on his side. Left a lot of spareable spares, and he's picked up all bar one. On that particular occasion, he stuck at the foul line and counted for nothing, but
that spare that he missed back in the fifth frame when he stuck a little bit or overslid pretty pivotal at this moment, because if he makes that, he's still well and truly in the match.
Mm. Still a little bit of pressure on Bob to make shots in the 10th, but after that particular spare, all he needs is good count.
Yeah, Rob's looking at the scoreboard, and he'd be pretty well aware that his situation's not a good one. Bit more room there.
Oh, he's definitely had the carry off that left board, that's for sure.
Have a look at the head pin, comes back.
Wow.
Takes out the four, proceeds into the right-hand gutter.
Who said oldies don't have power?
Oh, we still do. Summer's got a little bit more than others. Bob Whybrow at his age can still go away, represent Australia not only at seniors but at adult level, do so successfully, because he has enough power in his shot to get the carry when he needs it.
That particular combination you see there, folks, you don't see very often. It's the Greek Church minus the 10 pin, but it doesn't matter to Bob now. He is your winner. He might even go back and try and spare this.
Yeah, he's had a... had a go at it. Great effort there from Bob Whybrow. See,
the 9 pin there is a bit off spot.
Yeah, it is a little bit, and yeah, that might have been what brought him undone on that spare 10. Rob Szumski now looking to finish out.
Let's hope he can get a strike, for goodness sake, because he's been in the pocket the whole game.
Hair high this time. So much of the game today is about matching up your equipment with your release on the lane condition and the lane surface. And unfortunately, just on this particular condition, Rob just hasn't quite matched up properly. It's a shame, because if the number of times he's hit the pocket, he could have had a really big game.
The thing too that Rob is a regular bowler here at this particular centre, the Campbelltown City. So you would have thought maybe going into this match it might have been just a small advantage, but hasn't turned out that way.
I hate this. He's dragged out a different ball here, and if he strikes on this, he is going to feel terrible.
Oh, don't do it.
And that's actually a urethane ball, and even that still jumped through the beak. Bob Whybrow, though, with 203, has defeated Rob Szumski on 178, and he will go through to the next round. He will play Greg Williams.
It'll be Australian rep versus Australian rep. Go down now to Dennis.
Welcome back to the 10 Pin Bowling Show, where you saw an exciting match between Bob Whybrow and Rob Szumski. Rob, you're all around the pocket, just was not your day today.
No, I couldn't manage to get through. I made a few changes, nothing seemed to work. I'd just leave different pins.
It's the curse of the lefties, I reckon.
Exactly right. We've got to stick together.
I'm with you, buddy. Solidarity.
Thank you.
And Bob?
Dennis.
Your experience showed through today, mate. You threw a solid game, even though you weren't happy, as you said earlier in the telecast, with the way you're throwing the ball, but you did enough.
Yeah, I just felt I wasn't solid at the foul line, Dennis, but the ball, as you say, I was coming through the ball and I started moving my feet and got the ball a bit further out on the lane, which fortunately I carried and Rob didn't. So that's the way the game goes.
And I watched how you just made an adjustment to try to get a different read in the filler ball in the 10th. People at home might not realise that's what you were doing.
That's exactly right. Yeah, I was just looking to see where the ball was starting to hit the pocket and just moved my feet accordingly.
Mate, we look forward to seeing you in the next round. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And that'll be the end of this episode of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. Please join us again next week, where you see more continuing coverage of the Interbowl Senior Masters. Until then, good luck and high scoring.
The 10 Pin Bowling Show was proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.